To make an arcade controller panel, you're going to need the following items. A USB or PS2 encoder. You can use multiples if you require more than one player, however this may not be applicable for PS2 encoders, so you got to bear that in mind. You're going to need a bunch of wires. Now, usually, most USB encoders will come with these wires that you can connect up to your arcade buttons, so definitely make sure you have enough wire or enough wires to go with your arcade buttons. Now obviously you're going to need all your arcade buttons, joysticks and micro switches you want to use. Test the continuity with a multimeter to see if they work, so if any don't work, make sure they get replaced immediately. And of course you're going to need an arcade controller panel with pre-made holes to put everything together on. You will need to make sure the holes are made in such a way to accommodate the size of buttons you have. This can be different from a person to person, depends on the kind of buttons you purchase off the internet or wherever you buy them, so definitely check that the holes are the correct size. You can make this outside of the panel, but the wiring will make this highly inadvisable and an absolute pain in the back type to use. Okay, so depending on how you'd like your arcade controller panel set out, one thing is abundantly clear. You're going to need a bunch of arcade buttons. More likely than not, they're going to come with micro switches like this, as you can see. Now yours may look a little bit different, but the function of all micro switches appears to be the same. The bottom pin functions as the main connection of the button, or C for common, as some people seem to call it. The top pin functions as a closed circuit, and the middle pin functions as an open circuit. Now depending on what you want your button to do, you're more often than not going to want to attach the button via the common connection and the middle pin to make it an open circuit. How this functions is that when the button is pressed, the open circuit will become closed, thus telling the control board that the button has been pressed. If however you want the opposite to happen, where a button is being pressed constantly and you want it to stop when the button is pressed, simply attach the button via the common connection and the top pin instead. This will make it a closed circuit, and upon pressing the button, will open the circuit and sever the connection. Thus, pressing the button will make it stop sending the signal. Depending on the kind of joystick you have, will change how you will want to wire it to the encoder. You will need to check which direction presses which switch on the bottom of the joystick. For example, you may push the joystick in an upwards position, but it pushes the bottom micro switch, or perhaps even the right micro switch. This is because of how the joystick works. It's one long stick, and when you push it forwards, the bottom of the stick pushes down. When pushed left, the bottom of the stick will go right. With all this information in mind, you can now start putting together your arcade controller panel. I'd show you putting mine together, but I rushed ahead, and hindsight is a wonderful thing, ain't it?
Howdy guys, now the arcade cabinet isn't complete, but I've been putting it all together, wiring up and stuff. This is not the final monitor we're going with. The monitor I'm going to be getting is going to be a couple of inches bigger to actually fill up the entire screen, which will be nice, and obviously I'm going to mount it. Right now it's just set on the inside. But as you can see, we've got the arcade cabinet actually set up. Now, I haven't actually got any screws for the joysticks yet. So I actually used some drawer knobs, which actually works out quite nicely. They fit nicely. They're quite nice and snug, and it's quite nice. So, yeah, all the buttons are all set up, and as you can see, all wired up and good to go. So yeah, let's have a quick look at that wiring on the inside, shall we? Alrighty, so on the inside, as you can see, the USB encoders are both powered up and ready to go. All the cables are connected quite nicely. As you can see, they're all set in the open position, which is quite nice, because we don't want it to be closed constantly. Same goes for the micro switches on the joysticks. Now, as you can see, we got four on the joystick, and we also have the arcade buttons on the side for the pinball mans. So yeah, it's pretty good stuff. I'm very happy with how this is. I haven't yet drilled down the USB encoder, so they're currently just hanging there, because the cables are a lot shorter than I expected. But yeah, there we go. So yeah, that's how you wire up a arcade control panel, which is very, very nice, and now you can get up to some gaming. Alrighty, so this isn't only applicable to arcade cabinets. You can just make a nice, lovely control board like this, and you don't need the whole arcade setup. You can just put the USB encoders in a nice little square like this, put all the buttons on you want, and then just plug it into a computer whenever you want to use it. Put it on your coffee table, play arcade controls with on your coffee table, through your TV or something like that. That'd be pretty cool to do. So yeah, you can set up your own controller quite nicely here. So yeah, that's how you set up a arcade control panel.